If you're not a big fan of Power BI and want to work with large datasets containing plus million rows in Excel, here's a smart way to do it. If we try to open our sample data file consisting of around 2 million rows in Excel, we get an error message as Excel only supports around 1 million rows. Instead of opening the file directly in Excel, we must transform the data first. We do that by clicking Data, Get Data, then we pick from text slash CSV, as this dataset is a CSV file. Here you can select the type of your needs. We select our file, and very important, we press Transform Data here. If we press Load, we will get this error message saying that this dataset is too large. We promote headers, and in this case remove timestamps by extracting data before space. Lastly, we mark all columns and click Detect Data Type. In this example, we use dates to group our data into quarters. So let's press Add Column and add a quarter column. We can now divide our data into quarters. We rename the table to something meaningful, duplicate the table, and rename this one to something meaningful as well. Next, we filter on separate quarters in both tables and load the data. An alternative to quarters is using the index function. Let's look at that. We have the same dataset, but instead of quarters, we add an index column starting from 1. We duplicate the dataset, then select the first million rows, and change the filter to the next million rows. If your dataset contains more than 2 million rows, you can just customize your filter criteria to your needs. This way, we can split the dataset into multiple sheets and show all the data in the same Excel file. If you have specific sorting needs, for example sorting on date, we can go to the step before the index column and add the sorting order to our query. But beware, sorting will slow down your data load considerably, so only use sorting as a last resort. Lastly, if you want to have your data as flat data instead of a data table connection, you just delete the query and convert the table to a range just like this. And a quick reminder, if you work with large datasets regularly, Power BI is the best alternative. But if Excel is your only viable option, this is the way to do it. That's pretty much it. I hope you enjoyed. Please like and subscribe. Bye for now.